Hello, my name is José Marcos Ortega. I'm a professor of the Civil Engineering Department at University of Alicante, and I will continue with the videos related to the online teaching of the subject Structures 3 of the degree in Fundamentals of Architecture given here at Alicante. This video belongs to the practical classes 8 and 9 of this subject. In this practical classes, we are studying how to calculate the complex reinforcement of beams. And here, this tutorial is the second part of the solution of the design of the transverse reinforcement in an example of a beam. In the previous video, we have finished here. Here is this file in which is the solution of the exercise. We have finished here. We have done the first checking related to the compression produced by shear force. And now, we are going to start with the verification related to the tension produced by shear in the element. If we go to the summary, the summary is unit 243, schema cortante, shear summary. We have for an element or member with shear reinforcement, the two check-ins, the two verifications, and the verification two consists of this, okay? We must check that BRD2 is lower or equal than BU2. BU2 equal to BCU plus BSU. BCU is the contribution of concrete to resist the tension due to shear, and BCU is the contribution of transverse steel reinforcement. We use this equation or this checking for calculate the transverse reinforcement that we need to arrange in the beam. So if we go back to the solution, we have here the checking. And we will start calculating the parameter BCU. BCU has this expression. This expression, okay, 0.15 divided gamma C, the partial safety factor of concrete. This parameter is explained here, is 1 plus square root of 200 divided by D, being D in millimeters, and multiplied by cubic root of 100 multiplied by rho L. Rho L is the amount of tension reinforcement in the studied section, which is this expression is here, and FCK is the characteristic strength of concrete expressed in Newton square millimeters, and B and DB is the width, and D is the effective depth, and this BCU must be higher or equal than BU2 minimum. BU2 minimum has this expression. In this expression, the parameters has the same meaning that in the general expression of BCU. Here in one exercise, in the first exercise that we did related to design of transverse reinforcement, we calculate on one hand BCU, and we calculate in the other hand BU2 minimum. We can compare both, and we take the highest of both value. Another way to do that, instead of calculating first BCU and after that BU2 and BU2 minimum and compare, another way to do that is the way that we did here in the exercise. As you can see in the summary, both the part of the expression in brackets for BCU and for BU2 minimum is multiplied by B and D. Okay, so the fact that BCU or BU2 minimum was lower or higher than the other one parameter depends on this part of the equation between brackets. So we will take the maximum value of this one or this one value. We will multiply by B and by D, and we will obtain the corresponding BCU already including the comparison with BU2 minimum. The thing is that then we will take the maximum of this or this, and the maximum we will multiply by B and by D, and we will have the final value of BCU. And this is explained here, or this is done here. We have take the parting brackets of the expression of BCU, we have take the parting brackets of the expression of BU to minimum, we will take the maximum, and we multiply the maximum by B0, B in our case, to, because this is a rectangular cross section and the width is constant in all the session, and we will multiply it by D. So we are going to do that. Here the only thing is to calculate the parameters. This parameter, as I told you in the summary, is 1 plus the square root of 200 divided by d, and d must be introduced here in millimeters. D was calculated in part C and it was equal to 336, so 1 plus the square root of 200 divided 336 millimeters is equal to 1.77, and it accomplished that is lower than 2. So in the summary, it's indicated that this parameter must be lower or equal than 2, and this amount, this ROEL, must be lower or equal than 0.02. We calculate the ROEL. ROEL, this amount of longitudinal reinforcement, is AS1. AS1 is the area of tension, area of tension reinforcement in the studied section, divided by B, the width of the elements, and multiply by the effective depth. Here we are studying the section of this support, the support A of the extreme A. In this support, if we go to the solution of the part C, this is the solution of the part C, example design of beams, part C, complete solution, we have obtained this final solution. This is the previous exercise that we did, part of the exercise. Then in this extreme A or support A, the tension reinforcement is this one consists of in two bars of 16, so the area of tension steel reinforcement here will be the area of two bars of 16. For obtaining the area of two bars of 16, we can calculate it using the equation of the expression of the area of a circle, P multiplied by radius square, or we can go here directly. Here it's in the area in square centimeters. For bars of 16, two bars of 16, its area is 4.02. Square centimeters, which is equal to 402 square millimeters. So if we go back to the solution of the exercise, here we have taken as AS1 the area of two bars of 16. Here instead of 402 square millimeters is indicated 402.1 square millimeters. This is because I have calculated this using the expression of the area of a circle. Then I keep the decimal number here. B is the width of the cross section. If we go back to the wording, in the wording is indicated that we have a cross section, a rectangular cross section with 30 centimeters width. 30 centimeters is 300 millimeters, and the effective depth, as I told you in previous here, in the calculation of this parameter, is 336 millimeters. So if we operate this, we obtain that this parameter ROEL is equal to 0.00399, which is the same than 3.99 by 1000, and this verifies that this value is lower than 0.02, which is required, as I show you in this summary. So now we can replace these parameters by their corresponding values. Gamma C is the partial safety factor for concrete. We take 1.5. This parameter is 1.77, which is already calculated. Then the cubic root of 100, ROEL, 399 divided by 1000. And FCK, we have an HA35 newtons square HA35 concrete, so the characteristic strength of the concrete is 35 newton square millimeter. In this expression, please include this characteristic strength in newton square millimeter or megapascals. And for the minimum, the BU2 minimum, the same gamma C 1.5, this parameter 1.77, and the epsilon K characteristic strength in newton square millimeters 35. In this case, B, the width 300 millimeters, and D, effective depth 336 millimeters. We calculate this and we obtain 0.426 newton square millimeters, and we calculate this and we obtain 0.697 newtons square millimeters, and we will take the maximum of both values. The maximum is this one. So then BCU is 0.97, the maximum, multiplied by D and by D, 300 and 336. And finally, we obtain that BCU is 70,257.6 newtons. So in kilonewtons, BCU is approximately 70.26 kilonewtons. Okay, this is the contribution of concrete to support the tension produced by shear in the element. And if we go back to the checking, okay, we will have that BRD2 must be lower or equal than BU2, and BU2 is equal to BCU plus BSU. And here, if we replace it, we obtain that BCU is higher than BRD2. I remind you that it was 35.6 is the shear force, design shear force, defective design shear force near the support A. So we have this value, and BCU is higher than that, is higher than BRD2. So it indicates that the concrete can support the tension due to shear without adding or without incorporating a transverse reinforcement. Okay, BSU in this expression, here we have, this is, if we go back to the summary, here BCU is 70.26 and BRD2 was 35, I think, yes, 35.6. So BSU, if we do that, will be negative. This means that it's not necessary by calculation transverse reinforcement, because concrete supports the tension produced by the shear force. But as I told you, a beam is an element with transverse reinforcement. So we must to calculate one transverse reinforcement, and for calculating the transverse reinforcement here, we will use the conditions related to maximum spacing and minimum amount of transverse reinforcement, and we are going to do that now in the next or in the following step. The things related to the minimum amount of reinforcement and maximum spacing is indicated here, is in the summary. In the summary 243, shear summary part 2, after the page with this summary, we have the conditions related to maximum spacing and the equation or the expression for the terminal check the minimum amount. You also have it in this PowerPoint, in the PowerPoint Tema unit 241, ULS due to shear. In this slide, we have slide 16, you have the conditions related to the maximum distance or maximum spacing between stirrups for 90 degrees stirrups, the stirrups that we usually use in the subject. And here we have the equations of the minimum amount. So we are going to check this in the exercise. Here, first of all, for the maximum spacing, we must compare the BRD with BU multiplied by a fraction. Then we start with this one. BRD We have BRD. BRD is for this is the constant shear force near the support A, is the left extreme support, which was 36.8. And BU1 has been calculated in the first verification. B1 is that value.